In this video, Botanical Eco Dyeing Paper, how to eco print amazing pink paper with vegetables. Welcome to the I Love to Paint channel. This is your artsy friend Martha. If you are art inclined and love acrylic painting tutorials, this is your channel. These are some leftovers from the beets we had for a salad, and I put them in hot water. And now I'm going to put them over here on top of some deli paper. I hope I don't make too much of a mess. The whole purpose of this exercise is to stain the deli paper. Hopefully only the deli paper and not clothes and furniture and everything else. And I like to put them separate, one at a time. Although the deli paper doesn't attach to itself because of the waxy feeling of it. If you are enjoying this video, let me know in the comments and click a like, because pretty much that's the only way the algorithm in YouTube can check what video is working and what is not. And they keep changing things so much that it's pretty much the only way you can help a channel. So leave a comment, share the video, click a like. If you're new here and you like painting tutorials and all kinds of crafty activities with art journalings and painting on canvas, I hope you subscribe. This is still hot, so not too hot, but just kind of hot. And see if the paper looks nice, if the stain lasts after I see what I think will turn out to be. And because it is food, if it is an organic matter, organic coloring, I will be also giving it a layer of medium. But I know this is one of my favorite colors, and I know that the beet will stain nicely your lips, your cheeks, like makeup. And it stays in there for the rest of the day. How do I know? Don't even ask. So I will have this like so, and I'm going to add some of the chunks on top to test what happens with the cuts, if it is like extra intense. For now, just see my fingers, it's just there. And it is a beautiful color. I totally love it. I will add as well, maybe some printer paper, just regular computer printer paper, because it's easily available for everyone and also quite useful for craftsy projects. This is the computer printer paper. I put several pages in here. And I'm going to now wait for a few hours until it finishes staining, and then I will show you what happens. Well, one of the things that happened also is that I ended up with pink polka dots on my socks, but that's besides the point. And here are the dried papers with the vegetable dye, beet dye. So these are the tea bags. If you can see, they have a little bit of the brown and a lot of the beet gorgeousness. Some take more than others. I originally started with this. This was the avocado dye. And I added just little sprinkles of the beet that we had at the time. And I love the color that it was taking. So I put more. These are just not just avocado dye, but also a little bit of the beet dye. And these are the print papers. This was pretty much just the beet water. I made the dye. I put them with a little bit of tea in some areas. As you see, they got some stains. I love the variation of the color, like in the corner they got more, and that's what you see. And since it is pretty much like paper with some vegetable coloring, I'm going to be spraying them with my matte spray just to make sure that they're not going to lose over time the color. I don't think this is going to be acid-free paper, so I wouldn't recommend to use it on some like a photo that you care to keep, because this is pretty much an experiment. If you don't like the smell of the spray, because sometimes it's really strong, the Fix-It spray, because it gets smelly, after a while the smell is gone. But I have also here another way of doing things, which is in a safe, not sticky pad, you can use some of the matte medium and simply roll it or brush it. I wanted to do this one in particular because it has a tear with the matte medium that can be fixed by just literally just roll it. Another way of doing this, if you don't like rolling it, is by using your gelli pad. That is a very good way also. I can see how some of the color kind of smear over here with the medium, so definitely this needs some sealing. And this is the deli paper. Just gorgeous, just look at this. I love it. Different kinds of browns and reds. This one in here, this one. Somebody whose name will remain unmentioned put something on top. It was a plate or something on top of my art designs in the kitchen. How dare they? But anyway, I learned that just like with the rocks on the fabric in another video, this picked up some of the dye and left it kind of whitish with a mark. This was under it, so even the second page got a little marking. I found it interesting, although at the moment I was about to throw a fit, right? This looks amazing. I love how it is completely uneven. In the fold, it picked up probably more of the T than the bit. And this is like watercolor, pretty much. Just stains here and there where the water was ponding when it was drying. I absolutely love it. If you want to see the avocado dye, if you have not seen it, check over here in this video and see you there.